of the United Mexican States.
Thank you very much, everyone. It's a nice hot day, to put it mildly. So we'll make this quick, but it's all very positive, that I can say. And it's my tremendous pleasure to welcome everyone to the White House with my good friend, President López Obrador of Mexico. We've had a very outstanding relationship. Mr. President, we're truly moved that you chose to make your first foreign visit since taking office, very successfully taking office, I might add, to be with us at the White House. The relationship between the United States and Mexico has never been closer than it is right now. And as the President said a little while ago, people were betting against that. They were actually betting against that. But it's never been stronger, never been closer. We're doing a tremendous job together. We're cherished friends, partners, and neighbors. Our cooperation is founded on mutual trust and mutual respect between the two of us and between our two countries. And we honor the great dignity of both nations. With this visit, President López Obrador and I have the opportunity to strengthen the bond we have forged since his impressive election victory more than 2 years ago, a victory the Vice President and Ivanka joined in celebrating at the swearing-in. That was a very exciting day for them. Each of us was elected on the pledge to fight corruption, return power to the people, and put the interests of our countries first. And I do that, and you do that, Mr. President. The tradition of great respect between Mexican and American presidents goes back to the early days of both of our nations. And in particular, it includes President Abraham Lincoln and President Benito Juarez, who each held one another in very, very high esteem. They were great friends, and they did great things together, and we are grateful that this morning President López Obrador laid a wreath at the memorials that stand to each of these leaders right here in our nation's capital. That was a very beautiful, beautiful ceremony. Our countries are linked by trade and travel, by history and culture, by faith and family. The United States is home to 36 million incredible Mexican-American citizens. Mexican-Americans uplift our communities, and they strengthen our churches and enrich every feature of national life. They are hardworking, incredible people. They are also great businessmen and women and make up a big percentage of our small business owners and very successful. They're very, very successful. They're like you. They're tough negotiators and great business people, Mr. President. Working alongside President López Obrador, we're taking this relationship to new heights and building a powerful economic and security partnership. Together, we have addressed many of the most complex issues facing our two countries that really went unresolved for many years and, frankly, far too long. Should have been resolved long before I got here. But we're achieving great strides and remarkable breakthroughs and strengthening our relationship for decades to come. With everything that we have accomplished, the potential for the future of the United States and Mexico is unlimited. Far, far greater situation, really, for both countries than anyone thought possible. Today, we celebrate the historic victory we achieved together just days ago when NAFTA was officially terminated, one of the worst trade deals in history, and replaced with a brand-new, beautiful USMCA. We want to thank Canada also. I spoke with and will be speaking to the Prime Minister in a little while. While NAFTA slashed wages and eliminated jobs, the USMCA includes groundbreaking labor protections for workers in both nations. This landmark agreement will bring countless jobs from overseas back to North America, and our countries will be very big beneficiaries. We are already seeing the fruits because it started. It's the largest, fairest, and most advanced trade deal ever reached by any country, and it will bring enormous prosperity to both American and Mexican workers and Canada. We want to thank everybody. We'll have a separate the day with Canada. They're coming down at the appropriate time. But we want to congratulate Canada and the people of Canada, the Prime Minister. But this has been a tremendous achievement. It's actually the largest trade deal ever made. And we made a big one with China, too, but this is the largest trade deal ever made. Our two governments are also in close cooperation to stop the illicit cross-border flow of drugs and guns, cash and contraband, and very importantly, stopping human trafficking. We're forging critical partnerships across the Western Hemisphere to combat the cartels and the smugglers and to ensure safe, humane, and lawful migration. And we've been helped greatly by Mexico on creating record numbers in a positive sense on our southern border. It's been really very, very tight and done a great job. And I want to thank the secretary who's here. We have Chad, you're here someplace. Where is Chad? What a good job you're doing, Chad. Great job. We're proud of you. And you've worked very closely with Mexico. I know you were just telling me what a great help they've been. Right. Thank you very much, Chad. We've also worked closely in the battle against the coronavirus, together saving countless thousands of lives. It's been my honor to help Mexico procure 600 ventilators, and it's going to be a higher number than that. They needed them very badly, and we were able to make them. We're making thousands a week, and we're helping a lot of countries. But one of the first, and maybe the first that I spoke to, was Mexico. We have a lot of them in Mexico, saving a lot of lives. And, Mr. President, we're in this fight together, and we're doing very well. Just a couple of things on that. I'm proud to further announce that the U.S. is by far number one in testing, number one in the world in testing, and that the mortality rate is the lowest, or just about the lowest, of any nation anywhere in the world. And we're safely reopening our country, and very importantly, we're safely reopening our schools. We want the schools to be open and going in the fall. And most of them, I think, are looking at it that way. It's very important. We're finding out that learning by computer is not as good as learning in the classroom or learning on the campus, and I think you're finding that, too. We want to learn in the classroom, so our schools, we want them open in the fall. Following President López Obrador's remarks, we'll sign a joint declaration committing ourselves to a shared future of prosperity, security, and harmony. This is truly a proud moment in history for both of our nations, Mexico and the United States. With the signing, we pledge the close and continued friendship between the United States and Mexico, and we accelerate our progress toward an even greater tomorrow, and that's what's happening, a greater, maybe even a far greater tomorrow. With a prospering region, a flourishing hemisphere, and two sovereign nations thriving, growing, and excelling side by side, working together, and that's what we've been doing. Mr. President, we look forward to hosting you for a beautiful dinner later on this evening with some of your friends from Mexico and some of our great friends from the U.S., and it's an honor to have you with us, and please, we'd love to have you say a few words. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Amigas, amigos,
friends, ladies and gentlemen,
celebro este encuentro con usted,
with you,
Presidente
President Trump.
Mi visita obedece,
my visit,
en buena medida,
to a great extent,
a la importancia que tiene, sobre todo,
with the importance
en estos tiempos de
right now,
económica
in this times
mundial,
of world economic crisis,
la entrada en vigor del
the importance
tratado
of the
de
entry
comercio,
into effect of
entre México,
the Mexico-U.S.-Canada agreement to
Canada,
make by its Spanish acronym USMCA.
El haber conseguido este acuerdo,
having been able to close this deal,
representa
constitutes
un gran logro,
a great accomplishment,
beneficio
benefiting
de las tres naciones,
all three nations
y de nuestros pueblos,
and our peoples.
Como es sabido,
as it is well known,
América del Norte,
North America
es de las regiones económicas,
one of the most important economic regions
del planeta.
Of the planet.
No obstante,
however,
nuestra región,
our region
es inexplicablemente deficitaria,
a region of trade,
en términos
deficits
comerciales. Exportamos,
we export
al resto del
to
mundo
the rest of the world,
3.579 billones de dólares, pero importamos
import
4,190 billones de dólares. Es decir,
that is,
mantenemos
we
un
have
déficit
a deficit
de 611 millones de dólares,
billion dollars,
lo cual se traduce en fuga de divisas,
capital flight,
menores
less
oportunidades para las empresas,
for companies and businesses,
y pérdida
and job source
de fuentes de empleo.
Losses.
El nuevo tratado
this
busca precisamente
agreement
revertir
seeks to reverse
este desequilibrio
this imbalance
mediante una mayor integración
integration
de nuestras economías
of our economies
y mejoras en el funcionamiento
in the functioning
de las cadenas productivas
of productive chains
para recuperar
to recover
presencia
the economic
económica
presence
que ha perdido
that North America
América del Norte
has lost
en las últimas
in the last
cinco décadas.
Five decades.
Baste señalar
suffice it to
que 1970,
in 1970
la región
the
representó
region constituted
el 40.4% del producto mundial
GDP.
Y ahora
now,
esta participación en la economía global
global economy
ha bajado
has gone down
a 27.8%. Por ello
that's why
el tratado
this agreement
es una gran opción
option
para producir,
to produce,
crear empleos,
create jobs,
y fomentar el comercio sin necesidad de ir tan lejos
so
de nuestros hogares,
homes,
ciudades,
cities,
estados,
states,
y naciones.
And nations.
En otras palabras,
in other words,
los volúmenes de importaciones
import
que realizan nuestros países
of our countries,
del resto del mundo
imports to the rest of the
pueden
world,
producirse
may be produced
en América del Norte
in North America,
con menores costos
at a lower
de transporte
cost,
con proveedores confiables
reliable
para las empresas
reliable,
y con la utilización
course, and the utilization
de fuerza de trabajo
of regional
de la
labor
región.
Force.
Desde luego
of course,
no se trata de
it's not a matter of closing
al mundo
our countries,
sino de aprovechar
to the world.
It's
a matter of taking advantage of all the advantages that we have because we're neighbors, as well as the enforcement
de cooperación
of a policy
para el
desarrollo. Of cooperation for development.
Este tratado
this
permite
agreement
atraer inversiones
allows us to
de otros
attract
lugares
investments from other places of the hemisphere,
a nuestros países,
bringing those investments to our countries,
se
provided
con los principios
we comply,
we
honor the principles of producing merchandises
regional,
with high regional content,
procurar
and
condiciones salariales
also trying to have salary and labor conditions that are
fair
conditions for our workers of the exporting or importing countries of consumption goods. It's also important to point out that this agreement
significa
signifies
la integración los tres países
the integration of all three countries
aportamos
because we're all contributing
with productiva
productive capacity
mercados,
markets,
tecnología,
technology
experiencia,
experience,
mano
expertise
de obra
highly skilled labor force
complementándonos.
And we end up complementing
ejemplo,
each other
México
for instance
tiene
Mexico
algo
has something which is extremely valuable
y potenciar la integración
economic
y comercial
effective
de la región.
And to boost this integration
a su joven, creativa,
economic and commercial integration in the region. I'm talking about its very young,
no
creative and responsible
que la participación
labor force.
De los trabajadores
let us not
en
forget
that
the participation of workers in productive processes is
just
as important
que el papel
as
de
the
las
role of businesses and companies.
De poco serviría
it really would be
tener
no good for us to have capital and technology
si no
if
con buenos obreros,
we don't have good workers
que se destaquen
that are outstanding workers because of their imagination, their talent,
y su mística
and their mystic
de trabajo.
When they do
además,
their work. On the other hand,
con acuerdos como este,
with this type of agreement,
y con respeto a nuestras soberanías,
respecting our sovereign
en vez de distanciarnos,
states, instead of distancing
estamos optando por
we
marchar juntos
deciding, we're opting
hacia el porvenir.
To walk together towards the future.
Es privilegiar
We want the privilege, understanding.
Lo que nos une.
That's why we're united.
Hacer a un lado las diferencias,
and we're setting aside differences, or we are solving those differences
mutuo.
Through a dialogue and
ciertamente,
mutual respect.
En la de
certainly, in the history of our relations,
hemos
we've had perhaps moments in which our minds have not been
no
together, and there are.
Pero
there have been problems that are not yet forgotten. However, we've been able to establish explicit
de cooperación
agreements of cooperation and coexistence.
Por ejemplo,
for instance,
en los años 40
in the 40s
pasado,
of last century,
Guerra
during
Mundial,
the Second World War,
Mexico
helped meet the needs of the United States in terms of the raw materials needed by the United States, and it gave
its
support with the labor of migrant workers that were known as the braceros.
Desde entonces,
since
y hasta
then
la fecha,
and until now,
hemos venido
consolidating
nuestras relaciones económicas,
our economic, commercial, trade relationships, as well as our very peculiar coexistence. Cohabitation, sometimes as distant neighbors and other times
amigos,
as very affectionate and close friends.
También, como es sabido,
and it is
historia,
also well known, history
vecindad,
of geopolitics, this neighborhood we have and economic circumstances of both of our nations have promoted in a very natural manner a process of migration of Mexican men and women
Unidos.
Coming here to the United States.
Aquí,
and here we've been able to create a community of about 38
personas,
million people, including the children of Mexican parents.
Se trata
it
de
is
una
a
comunidad
community
de gente buena
of good working
y trabajadora,
people, good people, working
que vino
people,
a ganarse
who have
la
come
vida
here
de manera
to make a living in a very honest
y que mucho
fashion,
ha aportado
and they have so much contributed to the development of this
gran
great
nación.
Nation.
Asimismo,
furthermore,
in Mexico, más que en
more
otro
than
país
in any other
mundo,
country of the world,
viven y forman parte de
we
nuestra sociedad,
have in our society
a
million and a half of
de
U.S. citizens. They live there and they're part of our society. So we're not just united by geographic proximity. We have
sociales,
economic, commercial, social, cultural, and ties
Presidente
of friendship.
Trump.
President Trump.
Como en los mejores tiempos de
as in the best times of our political relationship
durante mi mandato,
during my
como presidente
mandate
de México,
as President of Mexico,
en vez de agravios,
instead of remembering
hacia persona, y lo que estimo más importante
this
hacia mi país,
insults or things like that from against me, we have received from you, President
algunos
Trump,
pensaban
understanding and respect. People, some people thought that
ideological
differences would inevitably lead to confrontations.
Ese mal augurio
fortunately,
no se cumplió,
this has not been the case, and I believe that towards the future
no
there will be no motive or need to break our very good political relationship or the friendship between our two administrations. The best president Mexico has ever had, Benito Juárez García, as you have mentioned, had a good understanding with the great Republican president, Abraham Lincoln.
Recordemos
let us remember
que este gran líder
that this great historic leader of the United
el
States, who was the promoter of the abolition of slavery,
nunca
never recognized
al
Emperor
Maximilian
imposed in Mexico
con la
through the intervention of the powerful French
francés.
Army.
No es casual
it is no coincidence
Juárez
that Juárez
lamented
Lincoln's
diciendo,
murder in the United States, saying, I quote, I have deeply felt this disgrace because Lincoln,
con tanta constancia y decisión,
who was
trabajaba
constantly working in such a determined
de sus
manner for the complete freedom of its fellow men,
de mejor suerte.
Was worthy of a better fortune or luck.
End of quote.
The same thing happened with the splendid relationship
las circunstancias difíciles,
that
el presidente demócrata
President Franklin Delano Roosevelt had with our patriot President General Lázaro Cárdenas.
The same situation took place.
And after the oil expropriation, in a letter, General Cárdenas recognized the good understanding, the good bilateral understanding as follows. He said, my administration believes that the attitude of the United States of America in the case of the oil company expropriation reasserts once more
la soberanía the sovereignty of the peoples of this continent
that with so much effort have
been maintaining
and the situation and the position of His Excellency, Mr. President Roosevelt.
Todas las proporciones end of quote. So, with all proportions, la historia
and
nos enseña,
all the circumstances, with different circumstances, history tells us that it is possible to understand each other without arrogance or extremisms.
Trump,
now that I have decided to come to this meeting with you, President Trump, we had a good debate in my country on the convenience of this trip.
Yo decidí venir,
I decided to come
ya lo expresé,
because, as I have already expressed, it is very important for us to be launching this new agreement.
Quise estar aquí
but I also wanted to be here
al pueblo
to thank
de Estados
people
Unidos,
of the United States,
a su gobierno,
its government,
y a usted,
and thank you,
Presidente Trump,
President Trump,
por ser cada vez
for being increasingly
con nuestros
respectful
paisanos
with
mexicanos.
Our Mexican fellow men.
A usted, Presidente Trump,
and to you,
le agradezco
President
su
Trump,
comprensión
I want to thank you for your understanding
y la ayuda que nos ha brindado
and the
en
help
asuntos
you've given us
de comercio,
in
petróleo,
issues related to trade, commerce,
así como su apoyo
oil,
personal,
as well as your personal support
para la adquisición
for the acquisition of medical equipment that we needed urgently to treat our patients of COVID-19. But what I mainly appreciate is that you have never sought to impose anything on us, violating
nuestra soberanía,
our sovereignty.
En vez de la doctrina
instead
Monroe,
of the Monroe Doctrine,
usted ha seguido,
you have followed
en nuestro caso, el sabio consejo del ilustre y prudente George Washington,
prudent George Washington,
quien advertía
who said, quote,
que las naciones no deben aprovecharse del infortunio
take advantage of the unfortunate condition of other peoples, end of
no
quote.
Ha pretendido
you have not
como
tried
colonia,
to treat us as a colony.
Sino que por el contrario,
on the contrary,
honrado,
you have honored
nuestra condición
our condition
de nación
as an independent nation.
Por eso estoy aquí,
that's why I'm here.
Para expresar
to express
al pueblo de Estados Unidos,
to the people of the United States
que su presidente
that
se
their
ha comportado
president has
hacia
behaved
nosotros,
with us
con gentileza,
with kindness
y respeto.
And respect.
Nos ha tratado
you have treated us
como lo que somos,
just as
un país
what we are,
y un pueblo
a
digno,
country
libre,
and a dignified people, a free, democratic,
y soberano,
and sovereign people.
Que viva la amistad
long live the friendship
de nuestras dos
of our
naciones,
two nations.
Que viva
long
Estados
live
Unidos
the United
de
States of America.
Que viva Canadá.
Long live Canada.
Que viva nuestra América.
Long live our America.
Viva México.
Long live
viva
Mexico.
México.
Long live
viva
Mexico.
México.
Viva México.
That's fantastic. Beautiful job. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mr. President. Great job. Thank you. And we will now sign a very important document. Thank you.
Thank you. México.
Philippines.